The Las Vegas Raiders' new regime just drafted a bunch of players that remind them of players they've had before. First-round pick Tyree Wilson is reminiscent of guys like Willie McGinnis and Chandler Jones. They said second-round pick Michael Mayer reminds them of tight end Rob Gronkowski. They call him Baby Gronk for a reason, right? Then there's fifth-round pick Chris Smith that they said reminds them of safety Daron Harmon. Then there's the ultimate. They said fourth-round pick Aiden O'Connell reminds them of seven-time Super Bowl-winning quarterback Tom Brady. Well, I don't know if he'll win seven Super Bowls, but they do have him set up to take over as a starter at some point this season, because starter Jimmy Garoppolo is going to go out at some point. I don't want to see that happen, but we know that's how it goes with Garoppolo. Some of you are going to lament the comparison to Brady because of what he's done over his career, but no one's expecting Brady results. All I'm looking for is for him to be decent when Garoppolo gets hurt. But I will say this. He may not end up as great as Brady or even great at all, but he does have traits in common with him. Let's start with the bad. Sometimes he just makes plain out bad decisions. There are times that he tries to squeeze the ball into places that he has no business trying to squeeze it into. His player comparison is Tom Brady, not Patrick Mahomes or Josh Allen. So scrambling around and making tough throws is not going to work out for him. Brady stays within himself, and that's what O'Connell's going to have to learn how to do. Now here's something negative that he has in common with Brady. No mobility. When you got him, you got him. He's not going to shake off a bunch of defenders and make plays with his legs. Now for the good that he has in common with Brady. He's extremely accurate, so he usually gives his guys something they can run with after the catch. On those short passes, he hits his guys right in stride. No adjustments or nothing, those passes are dead on the money. All his receivers have to do is catch the ball and focus on turning the ball upfield and getting extra yardage. This is important because yards after the catch are important on short passes. Look at this one. He gives his guy something to run with between defenders. He has the accuracy to fit that ball into tight windows, too. He can layer it over the linebacker and in front of the defensive back. He can throw his guy away from the big hit, too. He made a lot of tight window throws in comparison to a lot of the other prospects. Watch this here. O'Connell throws a dime, but this guy's gonna drop it for the interception. The ball couldn't have been put anywhere else on this one. Don't listen to the media. He has a strong arm. He could put some zip on it. He can zip it on that out route outside the numbers. Watch this throw from the opposite hash to the numbers. He squeezed that in there on Joey Porter Jr. too. Now watch this throw behind the corner and in front of the safety. He doesn't have that crazy arm like Mahomes or Allen. He has a strong arm, like Brady. The coach has to trust your arm to make this throw here. Another thing he has in common with Brady is a little pocket presence. He can slide around that pocket and get the ball off. Nothing spectacular in scrambling like Mahomes and Allen. Just a few steps here and a few steps there to release the ball. He was going to take a couple of steps to his left and get one off for a first down. And here he's going to get on the run a little bit. Here he's going to fade to his left a little bit and then throw a dime. Another thing he does like Brady is go through his progressions and process information quickly. Alright, he doesn't like what he sees there, so he's gonna pump fake it and not throw it. Now he sees a man one-on-one deep down the field, so he's gonna give him a chance to make a play. Alright, the tight end is being covered pretty well by the linebacker there. But on this mesh concept, he's going to see something on the other side of it. Alright, here we are in the red zone. We got another mesh concept. Alright, we can forget about the tight end because he's double covered. But bang, quickly move off of him to the other side and you got a man open for a touchdown. Alright, here we go again. Alright, he wants something down the field, but it's not there, so he's going to have to quickly come off it. And there it is right there. Check it down to his tight end. What happened after ain't his fault. Alright, we got another mesh concept. They love that at Purdue. Alright, first he looks toward his tight end, and he's running into a crowd. Meanwhile, we got a receiver crossing. He's going to beat that linebacker on the other side. So that's where the ball's going. Here's a full field read, just like he's going to have in Las Vegas. Alright, that's his tight end. That's not going to open up. Meanwhile, there's a linebacker coming, but the guard's going to pick him up. Now he's onto something on the other side of the field, and he likes it, so he's going to throw it there. I'm going to hope and pray. And when I'm done hoping and praying, I'm going to hope and pray some more that Garoppolo stays healthy the whole season. I just feel much better about the Raiders' chances of having a good season with Garoppolo in there all year long. But I will say this, after watching this kid on tape, I feel better about him than I do Brian Hoyer. And for better or for worse, I do see those traits that he has in common with Brady. He has a strong but not crazy arm. He's not going to move around much, but he processes information and gets rid of the ball quickly. Might be okay in the future, but let's keep Garoppolo healthy this year. Thank you for watching. See you next time.